to a country that I came from and live here. Now, two-thirds of them are here, and one-third of which are not. So now tonight, as all three of us, including the two-thirds that weren't before, are here, I have the greatest pleasure in giving you one of the finest acts to come out of this dressing room this evening. Ladies and gentlemen, Spark.
Your image lately, Dick. It's a little bit staid, a little bit conservative.
He speaks.
Only when it comes to criticizing people.
No use in lecturing them or in threatening them. They will just say, who are you? Is that a question or not? And you see that the plot is predictable, not new, but just as stunned at the things you will do. No use in taking their time or in wasting two times on a call.
This is one of my great friends in show business. Now, Dick, I want to tell me something. Now, what if for one of these people out here, what would you recommend if they really wanted to get started in the music business? Is there something that you could help us out with? Because I know a lot of young people out there are dying to become a part of the music business, and they want that opening. They want that. One little crack in that door where they can kind of shove that foot in, where they can kind of make that entrance into this world of music, where there's fast cars, fast women, and just good talk. Go to your room.
It's sort of strange because a lot of people have said, well, Sparks, it's good that you're back and your, what have you been doing since Beat the Clock, which that was probably the last known hit in Britain. And in fact, we haven't really been away. We've been, we've had 8 albums that have been released since Beat the Clock, and most of them have been released in Britain, but they just have had, unfortunately for us, a really low profile. Over here, and they fared better in America. So during the 80s, we were allowed to tour a lot in the States as a result of the popularity of those albums. And now that we've come back after all this time of being away, and there's a real genuine enthusiasm now for what we're doing and real great support from the company that we're with now, people have assumed that we've just been away in Tahiti, chopping down coconut trees and stuff. The actual song is a guy wanting to know when he's going to get his 15 minutes of fame or whatever in life. He's saying, when is he going to get to sing My Way? In the case of our video, it was a songwriter, namely Ron, who's writing songs for me, this singer, and he's doing all the hard work and labor, and I'm going off getting all the fame and glory, and he's kind of wondering, when is it going to be his turn in life?
He was born probably too. With a need for attention, and so early on it was sports, and then when that proved to be a little too hazardous, entered music.
Thank you. And good evening to everybody. Something for the girl with everything. I'll count this one down. 2 sets of 4 counts. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Something for the girl with everything.
Something for the girl with everything. because everything is everything.
Joining us this morning, guys. Russell, when you look at that video, I mean, which became such a massive, that song just became so huge everywhere in the world. What do you think about sort of the, where you've both come and where the band's come?
Yeah, well, we're really happy that there's a lot of newer bands now that are citing Sparks as being an influence on their career, and Justin Hawkins from The Darkness actually covered This Town recently, and so it's just really nice to know that there's this group of our peers in the, you know, in other bands that are just starting to cite Sparks.
There's